All right, big day today.
Trying to get this thing reg.
Yep, step one.
Vin check at least.
Yep. Out of state in Connecticut, you got to go through a multi-day, multi-step process. It's really, really annoying. Jazzy is literally taping the bumper onto the car at this moment.
I'm just paranoid I'm going to lose it.
But yeah, Jazzy just got out of work and Trevor just had me house sitting. He got fiber optic installed and Trevor's at work, so he called me and then Jazzy ended up coming over. I didn't film any of that because there was a dude installing shit like in his living room. I didn't want to film him because that's weird. But yeah, Jazzy's gonna get half of the registration done today. It's just sad that Connecticut works like this. Yeah. Like, he's gonna go through all this effort to get one piece of paper that on Monday, because today's Friday, on Monday he's gonna have to go get the plates for it. So, yep. Super gange, super annoying process to register cars in Connecticut. But, you know, let's pray for Jazzy. Hopefully all goes well. Registering shit here is such hit or miss.
It is a hit or a miss, because you're either screwed or you fucking get right through.
Yeah, and
you're
one or the other.
Skate right through.
Driving it on the street at all.
It looks really bouncy.
It's super bouncy. Like, the coilovers are super, super stiff.
Like, fucking 40K spring rate, dude.
Yeah. So, Jazzy's gotta get that sorted. Some new coilovers and fucking different tires. Oh man, you gotta check the.
I think every suspension piece is loose on this thing.
You gotta check the rack, the column to rack slip joint thing.
Today is a bad day to be a fat fuck.
Why?
Because it's hot out.
They got this under control or what?
Yeah, they said they're gonna come out. I said I'm just gonna be out by the car.
Right.
I don't know, it feels like something in the front end itself that was like...
Like LCA? Like,
yeah,
bushings?
Like on one side, you feel it like...
Oh. We saw it.
You see how much I was bouncing in there?
Usually, right... I've seen an S chassis where that gets loose right there, and then the steering column spins inside of that.
Oh,
but yours looks good.
Oh, like if the splines were
stripped? Yeah, the splines, like, fucking strip out if you do, like, a shitty swap. I don't fucking know, but...
Dude, that'd be
Yeah, I'd comb over the front suspension bolts. You gotta nut and bolt this thing.
Yeah.
Check the bushings. If you get the Villains kit, it replaces all that.
Okay. Yeah, the only thing I've done is just tighten the rear because the guy said that everything was loose back there, which it was, so he was an honest guy about it.
No shade, but after an hour later, yeah. We're finally getting helped here.
First world problems, dude. This is why I just don't fuck with buying new cars. Like, this process makes buying new cars in Connecticut the most miserable chore. Like, it's not even worth it.
Unless you get it in Connecticut.
True. If you buy a Connecticut car, you only need to register it. You don't have to VIN check it, but still. Like, where is the good 240s for sale in Connecticut? Where's anything good for sale in Connecticut? Other than brand new at a dealership. I don't think we have anything good here. Everything here is fucking shot. And everyone here is a fucking idiot.
Pretty smooth. Asked, kind of filled me in about the odometer. He said that he's going to take a picture of it, and that he said it's not going to affect what I've written on the other thing. It's just for the VIN check.
Okay.
Because I told him I had to fucking get another cluster because it didn't.
So you're telling me we sat here for an hour for him to perform a 15-second checkup?
Yep.
He was standing there for 15 seconds and walked away.
Hey, if there's a fucking line, that's what sucks.
Yeah, true. I'm just being a salty motherfucker today.
Too bad they didn't have somebody else here that could fucking...
I blame it on Trevor.
You know, I don't blame you for being salty.
Yeah, you saw the Trevor incident earlier today.
I did.
It's not Trevor's fault either.
No.
It's Frontier Cable's fault.
Yeah, that stupid fuck.
They sent a pallet of unregistered modems to the headquarters, and Trevor got one.
I wonder if they can't just check that shit. Like, don't you think they go to a warehouse and be like, okay, I need this, this, and this.
No, dude, the great resignation, dude. No one wants to work nowadays. It's just a big shit show.
Ever since COVID.
Yeah, they got a bunch of morons doing, like, important jobs now.
They're all making
or no, like employers are just desperate to hire anyone that will fucking apply.
Yeah, after.
It's sad.
Well, I think literally the government went through a year of people fucking slacking off. Like,
we're still in that period, dude.
Yeah.
Like, I feel like there's more traffic in Torrington now than ever before. Like, don't any of these people have a job?
Yeah, there's fucking mad cars out during the day.
It takes double the time to get across town during off hours. Like, everyone's out at once.
Yeah, if I leave to go get lunch or something, it's fucking packed out there.
Yeah.
Power Max? I don't know.
It says Power Max.
It says something Max.
And he has a cat sticker on the back window. Are you serious? No.
The DMV website crashed.
Are you fucking kidding me?
So I guess I just wasted everybody's time for fucking nothing.
Dude.
I'm just gonna get in the car and we head back because I'm really fucking.
This is so, like, today has just been bad.
What
with
happened?
Like, they fucked him. They gave him the money back, said they couldn't do it today.
Why is everything out of it? The guy said the fucking system went down. Couldn't they fucking tell me that earlier or something?
God. Salty onion, dude.
That kid of his shit was a Duramax.
Get to the shop, get grandma's vase going, get a couple Ronskis going. God, what a shit. Yeah, I re-upped yesterday. Ganjanomics, dude.
That thing is so fucked.
It's a little bouncy. I think the tires are too big. It's got too much sidewall flex.
Look at his wheels. Like, look at the actual wheels. They, like, move. Like,
worst case, you get a $1,000 eBay shopping cart together and you have every new suspension piece ever created.
Yeah.
If every arm was clapped out, it'd probably be under $1,000 to fix every single control arm. Watch the jack. Yeah, you're good, you're good.
So,
Quiet Zone and CTDMV screwed me. Of course, when I go there to get my VIN check done, the system goes down.
Yeah, and it's even worse, too, that you had to do, like, stuff to get out of work early today.
Yeah, I fucking hustled to do all this and lost out. So I guess I gotta try again a fucking different day.
That's Ganj.
I'm pissed.
Yeah, Jazzy, get the vase going. Oh my god, dude, no.
This thing, I'm going straight.
No, dude.
But at least, hey, you drove it on the road for the first time.
Yeah.
You see it drives like kind of dookie.
Yeah.
Now he can put it on lift at some point. Yeah, it's very loud. It kind of fucking reeks. But at least the one good thing is you got the dryer.
I don't think there's anywhere I can do it tomorrow. They're probably not open for VIN checks.
No, you're hit until Monday. Do the same thing on Monday?
Yeah.
You're better off doing it like Tuesday. Like, I feel like Monday's fucked too.
Maybe I'll tell them like Tuesday, I want to take a half day.
Yeah. Yeah. That's a good idea.
Yeah. Fit guy took the fit down. He's probably not selling it anymore.
Oh, no. The fit guy, dude.
Get Life OD ones.
We have a Life OD design, but it's like for like a pocket tee. It's like a channel art icon. Like,
dude,
it's not really a shirt design.
I think if you change it, you might fucking sell out of those.
Just because
it's
I doubt Life it. OD. Nah.
Buy the fucking merch. Maybe we'll give something away. We got lanterns.
Or if we sell these out, you give away this set of wheels right here.
Fuck no. Fucking buy the merch, boys.
Link in the description.
Dude, those would sell at like Lock City tickets.
Yeah.
Yeah, we're not selling the wheels.